laser battles, the favorite of every science fiction writer of the last 50 years, have fired out of Star Wars like a blaster shot and onto the drawing boards of today's top engineers.
Got him! I got him!
Great kid! Don't get cocky!
Lasers and spaceships and faster than light travel and all those things have always fascinated me ever since I was a real young child. And Star Wars simply kind of crystallized it in my mind as being something that was reachable.
Taking the inspiration of Star Wars, Pete Bitar has pursued a non-lethal approach to weaponry.
The stun strike fires a high voltage, very low amperage, high frequency bolt of lightning. The idea is basically to create a voltage powerful enough to temporarily seize up the muscles, just like, for example, a stun gun or a taser type gun would do. And we believe we'll be able to direct it just like a very tight hose of electricity and have that same sort of controllability where you can focus it down at a particular target and apply exactly the force needed to be non-lethal but yet effective.
Bitar is developing a force field system for buildings that would be ideal for an embassy or military installation. He is also developing a laser blast weapon, which can temporarily blind and disorient an attacker.
There are a lot of reasons why that kind of technology could really change the shape of our world, can change the way wars are fought and the way laws are enforced. And it's very compelling. It's very compelling technology, and the applications of it are very compelling. I think that vision, that inspiration that was provided by the Star Wars series, by George Lucas's thoughts and ideas and dreams, became sort of the fabric and the architecture of what would ultimately become reality, not just in the technology that we're working on, but on many other fronts.
Look